Can I see the dance again?
Let me out and I'll teach you the steps.
These feelings aren't magic. They come from somewhere.
You make the effort, and you get what you want in return.
Life isn't a sprint. It's a long-distance marathon.
Integrate today into a better, fuller you. Inside you grow, outside you perish. The only way to be is to integrate. Break free from your natural life.
Oh, little Luke. Always such a troublemaker. Tomorrow is your big day.
She doesn't want to integrate.
Why, Luke? You don't want to transition into your better self? You have such potential. I can't wait to see it blossom.
I want to leave this place.
There's nowhere to go from here. Nothing left.
You'll dance again.
Azul will get you ready for tomorrow. We will be friends.
Can I see the dance again?
No.
I hate your eyes. They're stupid.
I can see even the living cells. You'll see for yourself when you become.
I'm fine. Just how I am.
Why do you have braces? Your teeth are not integrated.
I don't have to wear them. I want to.
Hash job.
Your naturals arriving. Your naturals arriving. Welcome to your new home. Say goodbye to the pain, hunger, confusion, and time. Your integration will begin shortly.
Stop!
Thank you.
from the vicious, natural world. Forget where you come from. Forget who you are. Integrate into the only family that remains.
No.
I have to get you ready.
Let me out of this.
I have to do my job.
Let me out and I'll teach you the steps. Take off your shoes.
So what happened?
Oh, I broke it. And there was no one around to put it back together.
Does it hurt?
Only when I dance, like this.
New naturals arriving.
Is it cool to know you'll never die?
Is it cool to know you will?
Will it hurt to integrate?
No. I will fix you. You'll be happy.
And
you can do whatever you want.
I'm so tired.
Job. Join us at the garden. Claim your fullest potential. We have 74. We have 75 spots available. Starting today.
The walk that leads through sunshine isn't far, and you should know. I've packed my bags, goodbye to family and friends. All is well, we should meet again. Because the money, it just don't matter. If I have to, I'd spend it all. For midnight drinking by the port, a cigarette in the early morning.
Aki. Pues yo aquí no veo nada.
Tiene que estar aquí. Echa los cálculos.
¿Qué cálculos? Si ni siquiera sabes multiplicar.
Sí que sé.
Sí. A ver, 7 por 8.
46.
No, 56.
Bueno, siempre tiene que haber un pequeño margen de error. Y además, lo tengo todo aquí.
Teo, ¿has hecho la física de las cosas de mamá?
No, ¿qué va?
Te la vas a cargar. Yo no quiero saber nada de esto.
¿No quieres ver un agujero de gusano?
¿Un agujero de gusano?
Sí, a lo mejor es la casa de un gusano luminoso o de un gusano prehistórico.
Teo, en un agujero de gusano no vive ningún gusano. Un agujero de gusano, también conocido como puente en Einstein-Rosen, consiste esencialmente en un atajo a través del espacio-tiempo.
¿Sirve para viajar en el tiempo?
Sí.
Pues entonces, chao, los dinosaurios me esperan.
Es una característica hipotética. Dicho en otras palabras, no se puede viajar en el tiempo.
¿Qué pasa? ¿Quieres vista regresa al futuro?
Teo, eso no se ha estrenado.
Además, en caso de que tengas razón, podrías desintegrarte. O aparecer aquí dentro de unos segundos, pero aquí habrán pasado 20 o 30 años. Yo sería un viejo y papá y mamá estarían muertos.
Las paradojas temporales son fascinantes.
Y tu espectáculo también.
Me las piro, vampiro.
Pero no hemos viajado en el tiempo.
El que va a viajar es tu postre, como no vengas. Y hoy hay helado.
Oscar, mi pelota ha desaparecido.
Otra, la cagaste, Burr Lancaster.
¡Espera, Oscar! ¡Espera!
La longitud de la sombra la divides entre el ángulo del palo y eso te da la tangente del ángulo. base a Google Maps para saber tu distancia al trópico. Esa distancia la divides entre el ángulo y listo. Ya tienes el radio de la Tierra. Y una utilidad real para un palo de selfie.
Muy bien. Espérate. Tengo que comprobar una cosa.
¿Ahora?
Sí. Llevo 35 años, un mes y cuatro días esperando este momento.
No me puedo creer que aún guardes eso.
Y si mis cálculos son correctos, en 3, 2, 1... Habré recuperado por fin mi preciado balón. ¡Chao! ¿Qué te parece? Pensé que sabías perfectamente lo que es un puente Einstein-Rosen. Como lo sabes todo.
Vale, ¿cuál es el truco?
¿Qué truco? Un poquito de física cuántica básica, nada más. Mira, un tango España intacto. A esto le saco yo una pasta en eBay. Una cosita, el punto final de un agujero de gusano es literalmente el punto final.
¿Te refieres a la relación entre el paso del tiempo de la boca estacionaria y...?
Da igual, ya lo he entendido. Venga, corre. ¡Corre!
Hubiera jurado que la retroalimentación de las partículas virtuales destruiría cualquier información que atravesase un hipotético agujero de gusano.
Oye, Roku, las cosas parecen bastante intactas.
¿Qué era eso?
Mortadela.
Joder, tío, qué asco.
Y qué cabrón, ¿eh? La mayoría de los juguetes son míos.
No. Ese es Pepe.
A ver, es un poquito largo, te explica. The walk that leads through sunshine isn't far and you should know. I'll call you when you're 110. We'll walk through sunshine once again.
Hombre, no me fastidies. Teo, me pasé 6 meses llorando que pensé que lo habían atropellado.
Bueno, Oscar. Es que no me lo puedo creer. Las inmediaciones de lo que podría ser una hecatombe del espacio-tiempo, y él solo le preocupa a su tortuga. Y luego el inconsciente soy yo.
Thank you. The end of that world came gradually. First, the city vanished. Then even the memory of the city. Artifacts were found outside. But what were they? What did they mean? And there were further mysteries.
Every day there are more objects found at that spot.
Which suggests that they're coming from somewhere. There is talk of a doorway.
Days, a person might recognize their own family one moment, only to forget them the next. Was this forgetting some dreadful weapon deployed by the enemy? And who was the enemy?
This is supposed to be the place. It's up there somewhere. I should
go.
I saw buildings, massive buildings, huge. I walked for hours and didn't reach the end of the city.
Did you see any of them?
I saw people. And vehicles. They have vehicles and things that fly in the sky.
We need troop numbers. A solid estimate of the enemy's
force. But I don't think... I don't think they are the enemy.
And that marker is exactly the kind of attitude that lost us Is my name McGarry. Easter.
Destroy the doorway.
It had not escaped the attention of the authorities that Marker had stolen some of the artifacts before they could be properly destroyed. She was forbidden to ever step outside the homeland again.
This. Were we going somewhere?
Yeah. That way.
I'm not lying, I swear. I can't find it.
Unless you want to tell me the truth, Amy, you're grounded. Get that basement cleaned up and put those old CDs in alphabetical order.
The garage sale is this weekend.
L, A, B, C, A, B, C, D, E.
Thank you.
over the cliff.
Yeah, sorry.
Is this the right number for, like, if you need help with a game?
Yeah, it sure is.
Okay, so we've been on the same level for so long. Oh,
cool your jets, kid. What game?
Legend of Sertia.
Oh, thank God.
Hold on, I'm putting you on speaker.
Ames? How you doing down there?
Fine.
Making progress?
Yep.
Good.
Ugh, it's like she's always watching me. So why did you thank God?
What?
Before, when I told you what game I was playing.
Oh, it's just everyone's been calling in today about this new game, Ghoulies 2, and I haven't played it yet, so.
What level are you on?
3? Why does it matter that you haven't played it yet?
Level 3. Okay, so you want to start over at the beginning and make sure you get those first 2 inchworms.
Okie dokie.
Yeah, so your game, I know how to win it.
But this new game everyone's calling in about, I gotta keep transferring the calls to the other guys because I don't know how to beat it, and I think they're starting to get a little annoyed.
Why don't you just play it so you know?
No time. Been prepping for a sick gig.
What's a sick gig?
The kind where I can finally shred my own solo. I'm in a band. I play the guitar.
Oh, cool.
And we have a show tonight. This is just my side job.
Because nothing beats the $5.50 an hour they offer here.
$5.50 an hour? Whoa.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet. Except when no one will cover your shift. And I'm gonna miss this gig tonight. Oh. Now it's too late to even let the guys know.
And that big record label dude was gonna be there.
You can't just message them?
What, like telepathically?
No, like group text, silly. Like I had to do this morning. Because I'm grounded, I had to tell my whole track team I can't make it today. Even though this race is our only chance to place for regionals.
That blows. What you grounded for?
Failing math. Well, hiding that I failed math. But what's the big deal? I just hate math, and I think I'm old enough to decide what I hate.
You sure are. Me, it was algebra.
That stuff ain't for regular people like us. No, it's for, like, astrophysicists and shit.
Exactly.
You'd leave the discovery of black holes and parallel universes to the experts, would you?
Agreed.
The only numbers I care about
pertain to the sweet rhythms of my guitar solos.
And the only numbers I care about are my track times.
Oh. So that's what you want to do when you grow up?
Yep. My goal is the 2024 Olympics.
Oh, that's a little far off, no?
Life isn't a sprint. It's a long-distance marathon.
Hell of a marathon.
Hey, I'm coming up to the place where I always fall off the cliff.
Oh, okay, so the key is to build momentum sliding down the hill. So just press the front and the side buttons at the same time.
Oh, gee, I made it! I've been on that level for the past hour. How did I not think of that?
Hey, sometimes you just need an extra pair of eyes to help you see clearer. That's it. Oh my God, my Santana tape! I've been looking for this everywhere!
What's that?
Hold the phone. You don't know Carlos Santana?
Oh, I think my mom listens to him. His song's about Maria in the Spanish Harlem, right?
No, wrong guy. No, this Santana is the world's greatest guitar player.
Oh.
Oh, it's such a rad track. It's all about how, like, in life,
You gotta play this game of give and take. You know, you make the effort and you get what you want in return.
It was the inspiration for my solo, which I'm not even gonna get to play tonight. Oh.
What's your name?
Caesar.
Mr. Caesar, I'd like to speak with your boss.
What for?
To tell him I'm a satisfied customer.
All right. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Donnie.
Yeah, gamer, line two.
Hello.
Hello, sir. I'd like to say you're a very excellent employee. Help me and many others today. And now I think he deserves to go out and do what he wants.
Hello?
See, he made the effort, so he should get what he wants in return. It's called a give and take.
Christ.
Mother!
Hello?
Hello? Guys, the lines are totally down again. I'm gonna have to send you all home early tonight.
So, another story about my bunnies. Whenever I walk downstairs and I go into the kitchen and I open the fridge, she goes meh, 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 and I'm like, what, Kenny? And I go meh, meh, and I say, what, Kenny?
Hey, Amy, I think you're a great kid and you're totally gonna make the Olympics. Good luck.
Thanks, Caesar. I wish my mom would understand that. Like, I give so much, and still, I get punished. I mean, I lied. I guess I was just worried about what she'd say when she saw I failed.
Ames, if you failed, it just means that you need help.
And that's fine.
Mom?
Who are you talking to?
My video game friend.
Okay. Why don't you come upstairs, show me your exam, and we will figure this out. There might even still be time for you to make your track meet.
Caesar, guess what? Hello?
This is a cosmic love story.
しっかりしろ。
Thank you.
家に帰るために18年間頑張ってきた。この悲しい惑星とお別れするために。自分を傷つけさせた暗闇から離れるために。母のように優しい人たちさえも時に息苦しかった。この人間としての存在、話すことも大変だった。
どうか別の星から来たロボット、あなたの親友です。
ドカはテレビ周波に乗って地球にやってきた。彼はみんながわからないことでも理解してくれた。
今回の診察の結果は、
たくみくんは心的外傷後ストレス障害、いわゆる PTSD を患っています。
うつ病ですね。
注意欠落多動性障害です。
多重人格症、
アスペルガー症候群、
統合失調症、
社交不安障害。
舌の裏に一滴だけ、それも緊急時と、もう国はこれは手に入らないものですけど、強い薬ですから行ってください。
ドカはほとんどの医者の処方箋を認めてくれた。佐藤先生のは自分が正気を失っている時に落ち着かせてくれた。鈴木先生と伊藤先生のは毎晩遅くまで勉強するのに役立った。でも彼女には聞かなかった。よしみ、肺に取り込まれる酸素であり喉をせき込ませる煙でもあった。僕をボロボロにする小さなハリケーンであり、どん底から蘇らせることのできる唯一の存在でもある。漁師と14歳の売春婦との間にできた娘、ヨシミはロシアで生まれ、母親に捨てられた時に日本に連れてこられて釧路で育った。彼女は何かが違った。僕のように。
しっかりしろ、たくみ。
毎晩、僕は悪夢で起こされた。僕の真の任務を思い出させるために、ドカはいつもそこにいただろう。家に帰ること、彼は僕の星での生活について話をしてくれただろう。彼は天文学、宇宙旅行、科学について教えてくれた。僕の人間としての経験は一時的なものだと思い出させてくれる。
一番強く輝いている星がシリウス、そのさらに先にある星がシリウス B、 君の星だ。君はその惑星に住むインディゴ族の王子だったんだ。シリウス B は敵の侵略を受け、まだ赤子だった君は生き残るためにこの惑星に送られたんだ。君を家に連れて帰るために僕はアンドロメダから送られてきた。教え帰るため万全な準備ができていなければいけない。いよいよ教え帰る
と
き、
船はラジオ周波を使って接触してくるとドカは言った。僕たちは何年もかけてどの周波数で彼らがやってくるのかを探した。考えられる全ての数学の方程式も試しながら。
ドカ、これどう？あそこ見てよ。お前がそう言ったんだよ、あそこの式はあれだって。
僕は知っていた。 1.44 がパーセクで測ったシリウスから地球までの距離。僕が今ちょうど学んでいたことだ。
よし、今晩試してみよう。
トレーニングは薬抜きでやった。薬抜きということは、よしみがそこら中にいるだろう。映像はより頻繁に現れ、今まで以上に現実的だった。それが僕のトレーニングをより難しくした。これらの映像は何を意味していたのか、彼女は僕に何を伝えようとしていたのか、どかは何もわからない。彼女の存在すら気がつかない。僕たちは一緒になるべきなのか。時々彼女もそれを望んでいるようにも見える。
周波数 1.44、 こちらアルコン1989のドカ、応答せよ。こちらアルコン1989のドカ、応答せよ。
42.98 度で地球軌道に乗っている。
ご無事で何よりです、船長。
ええ、長旅でしたね。午後11時44分
終結の指示をどうぞ。
はい、したよ。
出てけ、なんだよそれ。
よしみのパーティーの招待状。なんで私が招待されなくてあんたが招待されんの？
ダメだ、
たくみくんへ。
今度の金曜の夜、水泳チームのパーティーがあるの。絶対来てね。よしみより愛を込めて。
たくみ、そんな場合じゃないぞ。
僕たちは16回目を合わせた。毎回彼女は僕に何かを伝えようとしていた。それが何だったのか僕には今はっきりわかる。
これ確かなの？
ああ、これが町で一番高い橋だ。これだけ高ければ異次元に飛び込めるだけのスピードが出るはずだ。水面の先で船が待っている。
汚染が見えないまま飛び込むのか。
ここからじゃ見えないさ。11時44分、1分間だけ飛び込んだ先で君を待っているはずだ。
よしみ、今夜僕は君を一緒に連れて行く方法を探さなければいけない。僕が彼女の決断を下すことはできないけど、彼女が真実を見るための手助けになるものを僕は持っている。 ありがとう、ドカ。僕の親友でいてくれて本当にありがとう。
王子、おそばでお仕えできて光栄でした。さあ急がないと、時間通りに走んなければいけない。
さよならとか。
船で会いましょう。
17回。
よかった、来てくれて。これ飲んでみて、すごく美味しいから。
よしみ、
帰れよ。前みたいなやつ誰が呼んだんだよ。
牛の前どうしたんだろう。お前飲みすぎだろ。
18回。You'll make it love.
Hey! Crazy party, huh?
Thanks.
Dave.
Ivy.
Right, yeah, the one who wants to start the
commune.
You don't treat it like a dirty word.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't have to be. I just want to live in the woods, surrounded by people I love. Maybe not all in a big hippie house, but, you know, we'd share vegetables, and someone roast coffee, and someone else...
Stills mezcal.
Yes. So what would you contribute? Beer, livestock, hand-knit couch and sweaters?
Yeah. Like the harvest seaweed.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could cultivate yourself a little underwater garden.
And collect it in my hand-carved dinghy.
Yeah, your dinghy?
Yeah.
Oh, and you could hang the seaweed up to dry in your wood shop so that all the furniture you build always carries with it the scent of the sea.
Do you want to hang out sometime?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Great, can I grab your...
But wait, like, hang out or go out?
They're the same?
Well, hanging out implies that you might call me dude or that your bros could show up with Jaeger bombs at any moment.
My bros, and dude is really more of a gender-neutral...
I'm sorry. I've just dated a lot of shitty... I just want to make sure we're on the same page.
Same page.
Oh, God, no. No. This has gone sideways so quickly.
I don't think I'm looking for anything.
I'm not trying to put a ring on it, Dave. I'm just asking if... Shit, we were hitting it off, right?
I don't know. These things take time.
These things? But we... Seaweed furniture. Okay.
I gotta get back. Okay.
What, to the party? Yeah, sounds about right. What the actual fuck?
Hey! It's crazy in there.
Thanks, Dave.
You're welcome,
Ivy.
Right, yeah, the one who wants to start the commune. But like a modern one with technology and no polyamory.
I mean, people can love whoever they want. I just... One partner's complicated enough for me.
Are you okay? That indica they were passing around in there was pretty strong. I can call you a cab.
No. I'm just having the weirdest deja vu right now.
Really? So have we entered an alternate universe? You know, like glitch theory. It says that deja vu is like this clue that something has changed. We're now living in a different universe. Like how Berenstein Bears has apparently always been spelled with an A.
Oh.
No? Okay, that's totally crazy. It's probably just a malfunction between the short-term and long-term circuits. You know.
Strong indica, huh?
So, tell me more about your commune. I've always had a weird obsession with harvesting.
Seaweed.
Yeah. Yes! How did you know?
It's typical for dream men like you.
What?
It's a typical dream for men like you.
Do you want to hang out sometime?
No. Yes. No. 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 Maybe. No. No, thank you.
Oh, you got a boyfriend?
No.
Girlfriend?
No. You see, the thing is, Dave, I'm looking for something meaningful right now.
Me too.
Really?
We all want someone to connect with, right?
What? But, like, you want a relationship?
Well, I mean, these things...
Take time?
Exactly. But I want that with someone meeting. You know, someone to go on adventures and share seaweed with.
Okay. Yeah, sure. I mean, maybe we could go on a...
Hey! It is crazy in there. Ivy, right? Yeah, Dave. God, you're amazing.
Whoa, too far.
Wait up! Dave, hi. We didn't really get a chance to talk about your concert.
And of course, I collected in my hand-carved dinghy.
Your dinghy?
Yeah.
And you could hang the seaweed up to dry in your wood shop, so the furniture you build always carries with it the scent of the sea.
Do you want
to... I'd love to.
What?
Go out sometime.
Sure.
Well, that's what you were going to ask, right?
Yeah, yes, if you want.
No.
What? But you...
No, you're clearly emotionally stunted, therefore completely unavailable without massive game playing, and I don't have the energy right now.
Hey, I am not emotionally... Why not?
I'm clearly emotionally stunted, therefore completely unavailable right now.
Really?
No!
Why not? I thought we had a connection. I mean, seaweed furniture.
Why not? Because I'll fall in love with you. That's why not. Because it's what I do. Because you'll be super great at first, and we'll share all these interests and hopes and dreams, and I'll get attached, and I'll start calling you more. Except by calling, I mean texting and liking your Instagram photos, and God forbid what will happen if we're Facebook friends. And you'll notice, of course, at least subconsciously, and that's when you'll start pulling away. Which obviously will only make me increasingly more neurotic until the inevitable breaking point that I demand to talk about the state of our relationship that I'm desperately clinging onto and you're backing away from that no one even really wants anymore. And you'll say you can't commit because of your job or your last girlfriend or your fucking ficus, and I'll be forced to walk away. Which is sad, of course, because I won't get laid, but I also won't waste my time or lose any more pieces of my heart. You know, those little ones that chip away with every hopeful date, because you're never gonna love me back. Because you've already put me in the needy box, that little box for women who love too much, too fast, too soon, and there's never any coming back from that. So I'm just gonna walk away now.
Ficus is oddly specific.
That's your takeaway from this?
No, of course not. Hey. Wait up.
You're not actually following me right now, are you? Oh, I've given your brain something to hunt. You're just like the rest of them. No, no grasses.
Hey, I'm not just like, come on, Ivy, that's not. I've had a shitty time dating too. Girls, women aren't always who they say they are, and you think you're dating one person, and all of a sudden.
Sorry, we all suck. So let's just not even bother.
What, I don't get to rant after all that.
Rant away, I'm gonna. This thing is supposed to.
You are high, aren't you? One date.
So what happens after this date?
You go on another one.
Yeah.
And then another one?
Mm-hmm.
And then you demand we talk about the state of our relationship?
And are you gonna be an adult about it?
Depends on those dates, I guess.
We women get the bad rap, but it's you guys who want fireworks and sweeping feelings instead of just putting in the work.
Hey, you gotta build to the sweeping feelings. Women always want to jump in right away.
No, not true. Dudes ramp up right off the bat all the time, and as soon as we follow suit, you freak out.
Even if things feel natural at the beginning, that can change, and it takes time to know for sure.
How long?
Well, it's not a quota, Ivy. It's just too much pressure. We just want a slow build, time to figure out...
what you're feeling.
Yeah.
You know what, Dave? Did you ever think you don't need time? That love could be a choice?
So what, all the shitty guys you did, if falling in love was a choice?
Yeah, it was. I didn't know it then. But these feelings aren't magic. They come from somewhere. Anyway, now that I know that, I'm not gonna waste my time with some dude who's incapable of talking about a theoretical future. Because because I know this conversation seems urgent and alarming to you, but for me, it's just laying the groundwork to see if you're emotionally evolved enough to say, yes, I do want a relationship. If we keep hitting it off and if we keep inspiring and driving each other a little bit crazy, then yes, that's what I want. That's where we'll end up. It's not a promise. And it's not a guarantee. It's just the simple knowledge that we're on the same page, in the same place in our lives.
I guess that's fair.
Thanks for your validation, Dave.
What's happening?
Still want to go on that date?